Hello dear kids, today we are going to study about base of geometry under the topic basic geometrical ideas. If you remember in your childhood when you were in pre-primary class, that is nursery or LKG, then how your teacher made you to learn to write the basic alphabets or to basic lines, that is she used to make some dots in your copy, like to show you that start from this dot and then join both the dots like this. This is standing line. When she want you to make a sleeping line, then she used to give you dots like this. And she used to say join the dots. So you used to join it like this. So what was the use of these dots? If teacher suppose don't give you dots and tell you draw standing line, so you will think what to do, from where to start. Yes, so copies mein chote bachon ke dots dete hain unko ek proper position batane ke liye ki you have to start from here and you have to end here, right? So these dots are called as point in the geometrical term. So first we are taking about a point. We just denoted like this as a dot. And these are denoted with a capital letter of English alphabet like this. Anywhere to show position of anything, we used to make a dot like this. A dot made by any pinpointed thing is called as a point, and it is shown or represented by a single capital letter of English alphabet. As this is, we call it point A, point B, point C, and so on. Secondly, we talk about if we have two points. If we have two distinct points, let us name them as X and Y. We have two points, and if we join these two points so that we can join them in many ways, like that if I join them like this in a curve, like this also, anyhow these two points can be joined. But if we want to join these two points in the shortest distance as much we can, then the shortest distance will be this, when we join them straight. So when we join two points straight so that they cover the shortest distance, then this is called as line segment. Line segment, that is a part of a line. Line segment's name is always denoted by two letters. That is because the line segment has two endpoints, and I told you before that each point we represent by a single capital letter. So as we have two points here, so name of line segments will be represented by two letters, that is the name of the point used there, that is X, Y. This line segment is line segment XY. अभी हमको कैसे पता चलेगा कि एक्स वाई है वो लाइन सेगमेंट है? सो टू शो इट वी नीड टू पुट अ बार ऑन एक्स वाई. द सिंबल शोज दैट एक्स वाई इज अ लाइन सेगमेंट. दिस इज द वे टू रिप्रेजेंट नेम ऑफ अ लाइन सेगमेंट. सो हियर वी हैव सीन अबाउट लाइन सेगमेंट. Okay, now line segment means part of a line. Then what a line is? If we talk about a line segment, that means it has two points. When we join these both, then we get a line segment, as it's a line segment AB. अगर हम इस लाइन सेगमेंट के जो दो पॉइंट हमारे पास है उन दोनों पॉइंट से अगर हम इसको आगे बढ़ाएं, अनलिमिटेड एनी हाउ, दिस एरो शोज कि वो कितना भी और आगे इस साइड जा
जा सकता है और सेम विथ अदर साइड ऑल्सो. नाउ इट इज शोइंग हियर कि फ्रॉम पॉइंट बी ऑल्सो इट कैन गो फर्दर एंड फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए ऑल्सो इट कैन मूव फर्दर, मीन्स इट इज एंडलेस. सो हियर इट इज शोइंग अस अ लाइन. लाइन हैज नो लिमिट, इट हैज नो स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट, इट हैज नो एंडिंग पॉइंट. सो नो एंड पॉइंट, दैट इज द लाइन. एंड हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट द लाइन? लाइन रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं हम फिर वही दो पॉइंट जो हमारे पास इस लाइन पे हैं, दैट इज ए बी. एंड एज यू कैन सी हाउ द लाइन इज, द सेम सिंबल इज टू बी पुट एट इट्स टॉप. तो ए बी के ऊपर ये डबल साइडेड एरो होना हमें शो करता है दैट ए बी इज अ लाइन. Got it? Now, let us take another case of this. Suppose we have a line segment which can move further at one side only. That the light coming from the sun, we call it sun rays. Do you know the reason? That is because from sun, when light comes out, then it moves in the various directions like this. These are called rays because these line type things are having a point of starting, that is the source of light. They are being started from sun, but where will they end? That we can't say. Wherever they will strike with any object, they will stop there only. Yes, so they have one end point, can be called as a starting point, but they are not having any ending point. That's why they are called as sun rays. That is, it has a starting point where it start, but it doesn't have an end point. So that is O, P. O, P is ray here. This is a ray, that is it has one end point only and it can move unlimited in one direction only. And it is represented as, again, the alphabets used in this points present on that initial and this at last. And the symbol of it is like a ray, like this. That is OP. One more thing is there. OP, you see how to write the name. In line segment, in lines, it's okay. You can write the name anyhow. I can write it line YX also. Line segment YX. I can call it line BA also. But a ray has a particular direction, so we cannot change, interchange its alphabet place. OP, ray OP means it's starting from A and towards P it is moving further. If I write it as ray PO, so I need to draw it like this, PO, and from P towards O it's moving. This is the way to write the name of these things, that is how to represent a point, a line segment, a line and a ray. Now to make it more clear, I'm taking an example here. That is, I'm going to draw a figure here. In this figure, if we have to tell the name of any two points, so we have number of points here, two R's here, so we will write any two. We have point B, point A, point E, point O, point C, point D, number of points. So any two I am taking here, A and B. If we are asked to name any two line segments here, any two line segments, that means it should have starting point also and end point also. So we can talk about DC. And also OC. Because we have both the points, the distance between D and C will be called as line segment DC. The distance between C and O will be called as line segment OC. Also if we have to name any two ray here, so we have here C. OB. O has the starting point, but from B it is moving further. So we have ray OB, and we have ray OE, OA, and so on. And this is the manner to represent them. Other than this, if we talk about the two lines or two line segments, then if we have two lines which cross each other at any point, let us name the point O. Suppose this line is XY and this line is AB. So line XY and line AB, as they are meeting at one point, that is O, so XY and AB are intersecting lines. These two lines are intersecting lines, and the points where these lines meet, that is called point of intersection. Here O is the point of intersection. And if we have two lines like this, you see, AB and OP are two lines here. You can see this, they both are moving straight as the rails, as the bars of the rails. You can consider a rectangular tabletop. The rectangular tabletop's opposite sides are also like this, that if they move further, infinite, even then there is a no chance that they meet with each other. That means they are at equal distance from any point. If we see here to here, suppose this distance is 2 cm here. So if we take any two points just opposite to each other, every time we will get the same distance only. So two lines which are equidistant from each other at every point, such lines are called as parallel lines. Okay, OP and AB are parallel lines here, and the symbol to represent it is like this. AB is parallel to OP. So this are the relation between the two lines. When two lines cross each other, they are intersecting. If they never cross by expanding at any side, even then they don't meet. So such lines are known as parallel line. So this is the base about the lines and the line segments in the basic geometry. Hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you so much.